The array modifier in Blender at its core creates an array of copies of your object. Imagine you have a single object and you want multiple copies in a row, a column, or even a 3D grid. Instead of manually duplicating and placing each one, the array modifier does this for you, and with precision. The modifier provides various ways to determine the length of your array. Fit curve adjusts the array length based on a specified curve. Fit length adjusts to a predefined fixed length. Fixed count directly specifies the number of copies. Remember, scaling your base object or the curve in object mode won't affect the number of copies, so you might find it handy to apply the scale sometimes. There are three core methods to offset your object copies. Relative offset. This scales based on the bounding box size of the object, so if you want copies offset by half the size of your object, this is the way to go. Constant offset provides a constant distance between each copy, irrespective of the object size. And the object offset uses the transformations from another object, usually an empty object. With object offset, you can for example distribute the objects perfectly at a certain angle in a circle. A powerful feature is the merge option. This allows vertices in each copy to combine with adjacent ones, if they're close enough. The array modifier is not a lone warrior. It often teams up with the curve modifier to generate complex patterns like chains or tentacles. The base mesh combined with the array and curve modifiers can produce complex repetitive structures effortlessly. Need some inspirational use cases? What about creating stairs where each step is uniformly spaced? Or placing windows on your architectural skyscraper? A cogwheel? Planning to create a stylized well? Well, the array modifier sure plays well. You will surely find something. Like many modifiers, the array modifier works in relation to your object's origin point, making its placement crucial. It's also essential to remember that this modifier relies on the actual transformation values of your object. To ensure precise offsets, periodically apply both the scale and rotation.